Back in 1994, a young programmer named Rasmus Lerdorf was fiddling with his personal website. He wanted an easy way to track who was visiting his online resume. So he wrote some simple scripts to do the job, nothing fancy, just something practical for his own use. He called them personal homepage tools. Little did he know, this small project would kick off something much bigger. As these scripts started to evolve, they didn't just stay a personal tool for Rasmus. They grew into a powerful server-side scripting language that made creating dynamic websites a whole lot easier. This language came to be known as PHP. But despite being so widespread, PHP hasn't dodged criticism. Some developers question whether it still fits into modern web development, especially with all the new technologies emerging. They wonder if PHP is becoming outdated in a world that's always pushing forward. Welcome to the story of PHP. After releasing his personal homepage tools to the public, Rasmus Lerdorf noticed that interest in his creation was growing rapidly. Developers were intrigued by the simplicity and utility of his scripts. Seeking to enhance their functionality, Rasmus began developing a set of common gateway interface scripts in the C programming language. This early iteration, known as PHP tools, didn't just track who visited his website, it also made managing content easier by simplifying tasks like adding or modifying information. As Rasmus described in an interview, "I put together all my common stuff into a C library, packed it into the NCS or web server, and then added a little templating system on top of that. It was a productivity tool for myself." By 1995, he released PHP-Fi, short for Personal Homepage Forms Interpreter. This version wasn't just about tracking visits anymore. It allowed developers to create simple, dynamic web applications. Its C-like syntax made it approachable for those familiar with other programming languages like C or Perl. But here's an interesting twist. Rasmus never meant for PHP to become a full-fledged programming language. In a 2003 interview, he admitted, "I don't know how to stop it. There was never any intent to write a programming language. I just kept adding the next logical step." Because PHP developed organically rather than through a formal design process, it ended up with some quirks, like inconsistent function names and parameter orders, that developers still chuckle about today. As more people started using PHP, a community began to form around it. Developers from different parts of the world contributed their ideas and improvements, rapidly expanding PHP's capabilities. Among them were two Israeli computer science students, Andy Gutmans and Ziv Saraski. In 1997, while working on an e-commerce project for a university assignment, Gutmans and Saraski ran into limitations with PHP 5.2. Instead of giving up, they reached out to Rasmus, and together they began rewriting the core of PHP. This collaboration marked a significant turning point. The new version included built-in support for databases like DBM, MSQL, and Postgres 95, along with features like cookies and user-defined functions. It transformed PHP from a set of tools into a true programming language. In June of that year, PHP 5 reached version 2 status, and by November, it graduated from beta. This was more than just a software update, it was the foundation for PHP's future growth. The language was becoming more robust, capable of handling the increasing demands of web development as the internet itself was rapidly expanding. In June 1998, with a wave of developers from all corners of the globe joining the effort, the new PHP development team proudly announced PHP 3.0 as the successor to PHP 5.2.0. Before it even had an official release, PHP 3 was making a splash. After 9 months of public testing, it was already running on over 70,000 domains worldwide. No longer tied down to just POSIX-compliant operating systems, PHP 3.0 broke free, opening doors to a variety of platforms. This new version wasn't just an update, it was a game changer. It offered advanced interfaces to databases like MySQL, PostgreSQL, Oracle, and more. But today, technology demands even more flexibility and power. Like BoxChat, this video sponsor unites top AI models to supercharge your workflow. Access ChatGPT, Claude, Perplexity, Stable Diffusion, and more all in one place. Now, back to our story. Developers could now craft dynamic, data-driven applications such as forums, e-commerce sites, and content management systems with relative ease. PHP 3 also dipped its toes into object-oriented programming, introducing basic features like classes, methods, and encapsulation. These additions, though modest at the time, were significant steps toward modern programming practices. Interestingly, PHP 3 began appearing on Windows 95, 98, NT, and even on Macintosh servers, a clear sign that it was expanding beyond its Unix roots. At its peak, PHP 3 powered about 10% of all web servers on the internet. Not bad for a language that started as a simple tool to track resume visits. But the journey was far from over. In 1999, recognizing the need for a more robust and efficient engine, Surowski and Gutmans founded Zend Technologies. They developed the Zend engine, which became the powerhouse behind PHP 4, released on May 22, 2000. PHP 4 was a significant leap forward. Understanding that PHP 3.0 struggled with complex applications, they rewrote the engine entirely. They shifted from the old execute while passing method to a more optimized compile than execute model. This change meant better performance and the ability to handle more demanding tasks. The new version also introduced crucial features like support for additional web servers, HTTP sessions, output buffering, and improved security for handling user input. Developers now had a more powerful and secure tool at their fingertips, enabling them to build larger and more complex web applications. Then came PHP 5, officially launched in July 2004 after years of development and several pre-releases. Powered by Zend Engine 2.0, PHP 5 focused heavily on enhancing object-oriented programming capabilities. It introduced access modifiers public, private, and protected, giving developers greater control over how data and functions were accessed within classes. But PHP 5 didn't stop there. It brought in the iterator interface, making it easier to loop through data structures, like XML documents, and database results using the familiar forEach loop. By this point, PHP 5 wasn't just popular, it was everywhere. Installed on tens, perhaps even hundreds, of millions of domains worldwide, PHP had cemented its massive presence on the internet. What began as a simple set of scripts had evolved into one of the most influential programming languages on the web. The plan of PHP 6 was abandoned, but its features didn't go to waste. Namespaces made their way into PHP 5.3, while traits and the short array syntax were introduced in PHP 5.4. PHP's early versions faced several limitations and criticisms, primarily due to inconsistent naming conventions and syntax problems. PHP's syntax was often pointed out as being non-standard because of the confusion created by the varying parameter orders and naming styles across functions when working with multiple libraries or collaborating with others. For example, PHP's use of the dollar sign was unfamiliar for developers coming from other languages, and the way arguments were passed by value or reference also demanded constant attention, or you could end up with behavior you didn't see coming. Also, these early versions struggled with delivering a complete object-oriented programming model and built-in data structures, which are essential for building complex applications. In the first version of PHP, object-oriented programming was not supported at all. PHP 2, 3, and PHP 4 introduced some basic object-oriented programming functionality, such as classes and objects, but these features were far from the depth offered by languages like Java or C at the time. Even in PHP 5, which brought the most significant advancements with Zend Engine 2.0 and claimed to offer a more mature model, the language still lacked advanced data structures and algorithms compared to languages like Java and Python. These languages had rich standard libraries packed with features such as heaps, dictionaries, and efficient sorting algorithms, elements that PHP developers often had to recreate or source through third-party libraries. Other problematic issues shown in security vulnerabilities, specifically PHP 1 through PHP 4, were highly criticized for having numerous security flaws, such as PHP's lack of built-in security mechanisms, exposing applications to common web attacks like SQL injection, where hackers manipulate a website's database query by inserting malicious code into input fields, such as a login form. Additionally, cross-site scripting occurs when attackers inject malicious scripts into web pages viewed by other users, allowing them to steal cookies, session tokens, or other sensitive information from users. Even with PHP 5, a related version, 5.3.15 was found to have multiple high-risk vulnerabilities related to buffer overflows and improper input validation, leading to more open threats. However, in 2015, PHP introduced a significant change with the release of PHP 7, powered by the Zend Engine 3.0. This release was a game changer, with scripts running nearly twice as fast as they did in PHP 5.6. Memory usage was optimized, and consistent 64-bit support was introduced, resolving compatibility issues across different platforms. A major focus was on overcoming the error handling problems that had plagued earlier versions. PHP 7 introduced exception handling, allowing developers to catch and handle errors centrally, rather than displaying them directly in the browser. This improved both user experience and application stability. Now, exceptions were thrown when an error occurred, rather than stopping the entire script, which had been a common issue in previous versions. PHP 7 also silenced critics who had pointed out the limitations in PHP's data handling. It introduced scalar type declarations, enabling developers to specify whether a parameter should be an integer, float, string, or Boolean. This led to more correct and well-documented programs, providing developers with more control over their code while also making it easier to read and maintain. The updates didn't stop, and after four successful versions of PHP 7, PHP 8 was released in 2020, adding impressive advancements, including named arguments, union types providing variables to hold multiple types, and attributes, which allowed developers to add metadata to classes, methods, and properties. Additionally, constructor property promotion, match expressions, and the null-safe operator were introduced. However, despite the major enhancements in PHP 7 and 8, millions of applications continued to rely on older PHP versions. In 2019, PHP 5 reached its end of life and stopped receiving security updates, leaving websites running on outdated versions vulnerable to attacks. Pushing for migration to PHP 7 and 8 became urgent, but many developers found the transition challenging due to deprecated functions and changes in behavior. Over the years, data has claimed that PHP may face extinction in the future, but this is unlikely. It has consistently overcome criticism with every new release and feature update. PHP remains a popular scripting language, used by millions of websites and applications. It continues to be updated and improved by the active PHP community. While it may not be as trendy as some newer languages such as Python or JavaScript, we cannot ignore the fact that it powers some of the world's largest platforms like WordPress and Wikipedia. Imagine if PHP were to disappear, these major platforms would either vanish or be forced to switch to other programming languages. This transition would require significant investments of time, money, and effort, causing major disruptions to development ecosystems. Such a scenario is hard to envision. Looking at the job market side, PHP remains in high demand, ranking among the top 10 most in-demand coding languages. The PHP community is highly active. In conclusion, PHP is not dying anytime soon. The language has consistently improved in performance, usability, and developer experience. As the community grows and the language evolves, PHP predictably has a chance to grow even more in the future.